This is me at my most masochistic.
Day two of our games training camp started out at
the pool.
Oh, baby, we're in the water. All right, so the training session that we what we
I feel like I'm definitely clicking out of this video.
You got tested today?
I did. I drug tested. Some dude had to watch me pee, and that's it. I'm not nervous. Keep our sport clean.
Feel too.
I just think it, I like swimming. I mean, it's a good mix because we have like a gymnastics movement with the bar muscle, or the muscle up. They were really hard. It felt like doing a strict muscle up, kind of. Clean and jerks were actually really fun because it was kind of like a break outside of the water.
Do you have a swimming background?
Nope. I don't have a swimming background. I just swim once a week all year long. And I feel like it just keeps me in good, like, swimming shape. But then also, I just feel comfortable in a pool.
Would you say your spirit animal is a dolphin, or?
I would say so, yeah. Be on the lookout for a super cool shirt. Yeah, I wish there was dolphins in this pool. Like, when I was in fifth grade or something, my parents took me to swim with dolphins. And it was, like, one of the best days of my life.
What do you know about dolphins? Do you have any fun facts about dolphins? Perfect, that's all I needed. Do you know any dolphin facts? Any fun dolphin trivia?
Dolphins are great in the water. That's what dolphin fact.
Thank you.
About dolphins?
Yeah.
They're not safe for work.
They are, I think, the only other animal that has sex for pleasure. I think. You gotta double check that.
You know anything about dolphins?
No.
You ever met a dolphin?
Never.
Do you know what noise a dolphin makes?
Everyone knows it's Lotto. That first part was kind of mimicking what you might see in an event at CrossFit. Then we spent about an hour doing some just technical work on diving and then also on doing bike intervals into 100 swim. So yeah. That way the athletes could get a feel for what the pace is like having to swim after doing bike sprints. So we did 30 seconds at kind of like a 5 minute pace for two rounds. And then we did 15 seconds at a full sprint into 100 swim. And then athletes did some kick conditioning.
Yeah, as you said, when your breathing is really compromised and trying to hold your breath pattern while you're stroke, it's very, very different.
Yeah.
It's almost like you feel like you're drowning when you're not. Yeah.
And we had K-Dog joined us.
Oh, yes, we did have Caden. Caden has been a CrossFit Games athlete in the teen 14 and 15 division, moved up to the 16, 17 this year, missed out on getting
to the... I told him not
to.
I was like, you told him not to stay in the 14, 15.
Then we came back for session two, which I think this one was my favorite workout of the weekend.
Favorite workout alert.
So we did 2 minute window, echo bike, 16 cals for the guys, 12 cals for the girls, 9 burpee box jump overs to the 30 or 24s, and then AMRAP dumbbell snatches at the 100 or the 70 up until the 2 minute mark. Then a 1 minute rest. It was 4 rounds of that or finishing off, finishing 40 reps.
Yeah.
So either it's an AMRAP or if you finish 40, that was your time. So really, we constructed this workout in a way that it was almost possible for an athlete to take a risk to break it. That was kind of our goal.
We wanted it to look like, look on paper and think, all right, I can finish this in 2 rounds, but I really, really have to take a risk on it. It's not something like, oh, I can bike at threshold pace and I can move nice and smooth in my burpees and then rip the dumbbell. It's like, no, you have to hammer each one of those components for 2 rounds in a row and trust that you can recover in between those rounds. So we knew it was going to be a risk. We wanted somebody to come out, and then the idea was that they'd have to take that risk, realize 2 wasn't in the cards, and try and figure out how to recover for 3. Yes. Travis.
36. Yep. 37. Come on.
38. 10 seconds. 39. Lock it out. Good. Get over.
And then, after Max, after Travis finished the 40 reps, he's going into the third round with everybody else.
One more.
So me and Travis talked about a lot of our training at this point is not, it's not really the technical side of CrossFit or the mechanical side or the strategic side. It's having a mindset that is able to compete under high levels of pressure and high levels of duress where it's easy to get distracted or lost in the crowd or lost in a race or lost in your pain and not finish the event. So we have a good working relationship now where there's less questioning when I do crazy shit.
Yeah.
And there's less questioning if I ask him to try crazy shit in training. So before this workout, I said, look, if this were the final event of the CrossFit Games and you needed to go there to try to get on the podium, you'd probably try to finish it too. Or somebody would probably try to finish it too. So make a decision to try it. And if you can't hold on, figure it out. Like don't use it as an excuse to slow down. Just figure out in the moment how to go out hot and get it done. I didn't really expect for him to finish. I thought that he would get just short of finishing and have to do three, but he stepped up and finished all 40, and I was like, holy shit, he just touch and go snatch a 100-pound dumbbell for 19 reps at the end of all this work. And his face was like,
he was, he already had no blood in his body from selling his soul. And then whatever was left drained completely out when he realized he had to go and do it again.
He went into full pasty warrior mode.
Travis, fuck off!
He's a dude and a friend to everyone. Travis Mayer, he's a CrossFit fan. Travis Mayer, the pasty warrior.
Hyper Vault! VL Ricky, I want my coach back.
Yeah, God bless him. But I mean, honestly, like the years that you guys have put together to be able to allow him to have that trust in you to be like, all right, he's doing this for my good, right?
Like
he's
doing
this to benefit me.
Not to watch him suffer.
No, that was really cool to see that he just sort of accepted it. I mean, so say that he's at the games and he actually gets a no rep on his 40th and he has to go and do it even though he actually did the work. Yeah. Like you just got to accept that and not question it in the moment.
Yeah.
You have this inner conflict of, I just busted my butt to be done. I don't know if I want to go again, but then I'll say, no, this is what's going to make you better. Just like, figure out a way to recover. And then when I got back to the bike, like I was messed up.
He had the look of like, it looked like if a man had just had food poisoning, it's coming out both ends, and then the fucking tornado siren goes on.
You gotta
start moving.
And it was interesting because that third interval was not good.
And
I get it. He literally sold his whole fitness to get out there. He goes through the whole interval number three, which technically he wouldn't have had to do because he finished the workout. And I told him, hey, you can stop even though you didn't get to my arbitrary 40 that I laid out. But he wasn't satisfied with his effort, so he ended up doing that last interval anyways.
When I finished, he was like, just stop. But then that like 40 seconds of like knowing I didn't push there as hard as I had. Because that's the stuff that will matter on game day. And this is what training's for, is to find out what you're comfortable with. And last night when I was sitting in the sauna, I made a point of, if I'm given an opportunity to race and push, to do that and accept it. And I would say that today that was accepting that and being able to keep pushing. So it was a big win.
These are moments that make me question coaching this sport. Like, it's challenging to ask somebody to do that, because I feel almost like a masochist. Like I'm asking them to go into this crazy place that I wouldn't maybe necessarily go into. And I remember looking around and the coaches, like all of them being like,
going again?
Nah. Say we're bad in the workout. Just working on it a little more. That echo bike killed me. That was where I lost it. It's hard to pace because you want to stay with the pack but not die out on the dumbbell.
What flavor is it?
Blue raspberry.
Are there blue raspberries?
Yeah, are there blue raspberries? I don't think so. Did they just need a blue flavor? So they were like raspberry, but make it blue? Man, a blue raspberry would taste so good though.
What the hell did you just say?
It was hard. That dumbbell, it's not light. It was fun though. And you know what? All the haters. get stuck.
Hold up. Wait a minute.
All right. And then the final workout of the day, we did evening strength work on Tuesday. We did power clean, hang power clean, split jerk.
Because you're about to watch a handful of stuff shot from angles that you don't understand why they're shooting from those angles.
Well done, my friend.
We did some dumbbell bench press.
Because you're about to watch a handful of stuff shot from angles that you don't understand why they're shooting from those angles.
Hand over hand rope sled drags.
Why they're shooting from those angles.
And some dumbbell front raises, dumbbell lateral raises, and tall kneeling overhead rope tricep extensions.
Why they're shooting from those angles.
Everybody was saying afterwards how blown up their biceps were,
yeah.
Which impacted going to the rope climbs on day three.
Oh, baby.
Teaser.
Teaser alert. All right, that's day two, everyone. Join us for day three, four, five, and
six. Maybe six.
Travis Mayer, he's a dude and a friend to everyone. Travis Mayer, he's a CrossFit kind of guy. Travis Mayer, the pasty warrior.
Yeah.